It's Smart Arts with Yanni Johns and Graham Baltram, Wendy Bills and David Harkin, sponsor of Plein Air Exhibition at Gosford Regional Gallery, join us in the Fishbowl studio to talk about, art, which is good because the musicians have been taking over Smart Arts.
We've got
to get the balance right, haven't we?
We have to, but it's still, it's pretty cool. All of it's good. I might just get you to move around with them so I can get you on camera.
Excellent stuff. Yeah. I'm looking at some beautiful, beautiful paintings that are going to be part of this Plein Air exhibition, which came out of the wonderful Five Lands Walk, which is the big cultural community event, which is going to be a real highlight of it.
Yeah, it was a fabulous day. I got stuck up on the skin. Where were you painting?
Wendy, I was opposite you, Yanni.
To get about a hand span from the mic if you're going to talk, Wendy.
And I was on the platform across from you.
Oh, that's right, down there. And Graham was on the beach.
I was almost on the beach, yeah, on the grass.
And David was probably fighting some big legal case in Sydney.
No, it was a Saturday, wasn't it?
In a pub somewhere.
So welcome all. And so tonight is the culmination of a few weeks of work from the Plein Air Five Lands Walk thing to going back to your studios and working on something that was inspired by the day. So tell us a little bit about your work.
Yeah, we all got out to Terrigal, and it was like this about a day before we went, but the day was really good. Sun came out. There's about 14 artists out there, and everybody done something different.
Yep.
Scattered from the end of the beach right up to the skillion where you were. And then after the day, we all went back to our studios and tried to think of what we'd paint out of that.
So, yeah, I think the idea was to, it was a Paul Haggath initiative, if you can say that, and with your support and ideas too, Yanni. But the idea was to take the artists outside, out of their comfort zone really, and then see what they could create in their own studio in a sort of the environment that they're used to.
Yeah.
So it was a very interesting one because we had to tackle the elements and the discomfort of being outside, which was some.
It is nice to get out of your comfort zone.
And poor old Paul Haggath, for being a very keen surfer, there's a perfect little bank, just this lovely little left-hander breaking right in front of him where he was near the lagoon at Terrigal, and it was crying out to be ridden, and he had to sit there and paint. And he couldn't go out and ride his surfboard, and so that was his penance for his art, wasn't it?
But that's what he does. If he can't ride them, he paints them.
Mm.
Whichever way it goes, he does the wave.
He brings water to life, doesn't
yeah,
he? It's quite
does.
Extraordinary technique.
And David's come on board to give this. And like so far, we've got two dimensions. We've got the plein air painting, stretching the artist. Then we've got, going back to our studios with the inspiration. And then it's like the Melbourne Cup. There's a winner. So, fortunately, we have a lovely sponsor here, David Harkin, who's a barrister from Sydney. And he's put up a few hundred dollars worth of prize money in art supplies so that you can go back and work on, because they're going to try and make it an annual exhibition.
We also want to talk to David about...
Yeah.
Because David loves his art and loves the artists. He sees them... There's great people in the community who we should look after, but sometimes they get exploited, don't they? I've been reading some horror stories in the popular press of late.
Of galleries that have really ripped off these kind souls like Yanni and Graham.
Goes on.
How can you help them from a legal perspective?
Well, I'm afraid sitting here next to Graham, I've just realised that I have one of his artworks in my kitchen, which I'm sure I didn't pay enough for. So I'll slip him a quick 50.
Oh my God, it's on radio now.
But the important thing I think for artists to remember is that everything is negotiable, and they should know what their work is worth, some idea of what the market value is, and if they feel uncomfortable about negotiating, get someone to negotiate for them. That doesn't have to be a lawyer. It can be a friend who has some knowledge of the industry, anybody. But if you're not comfortable, don't get ripped off. Go out there and get someone to do the negotiating for you.
So sometimes we all have that little alarm bell ringing at the back of the brain when someone just doesn't feel right to us. They feel a little bit... don't you? If you follow your instincts, you usually know if someone's a bit shonked.
So I usually end up married to them.
I can relate. relate to that.
You should be a divorce lawyer.
There's a big trend now to vanity galleries. I don't know if you've ever heard of them, where, you know, artists just want to express themselves and get their work in public. So there's galleries out there now that are enticing artists, you know, I want you to have a show at our gallery. But when you get there, it's like a $5,000 bill for the rent. There's 50% commission. There's all the other stuff, the value-added stuff, like making all the invitations, even $2 a word for, you know, for the publicity. So, you know, is there some way that artists can cushion themselves from that effect, or is it just like, you got to go pay it and suck eggs if you don't sell anything?
Certainly if someone's doing that to you at the last moment possible, and therefore putting you in that very difficult position, that has implications in terms of the Trade Practices Act, in terms of unconscionable conduct. So there are remedies in law for that sort of thing.
Yeah.
It just depends, obviously, on the situation, and I'm sure you would never get in that circumstance.
Oh, I all the time.
Pretty savvy, but there are lots of lecturers who suck off artistic people, aren't they? Yeah. And it's in the music game as well. You hear some absolute horror stories.
It's big now.
Poor creative people. Sometimes are naive, but sometimes are.
I think we're so desperate to get out there and things are hard that we take our risk and we want to believe that it's not going to be wrong. But, yeah, that thing in the back of our head does signify a lot, yeah. And we should obey it, but sadly we're so desperate we don't always.
We have a sort of a form contract for galleries, sign this sort of thing. Is that yours there, Graeme?
No.
Can you have something that would fit the bill?
But what I would encourage people to do is to remember that when they're entering into a contract, they can put anything they like in it. Their contract.
Right.
If somebody's proffering them a contract, they don't need to accept it. They can look at it, make changes, take it away, get advice. People should never feel, and particularly artists shouldn't feel, that they're being painted into a corner, so to speak.
Gee whiz, there's some really nice art that's on display at this exhibition, and it's a wonderful thing that's come out of the Five Lands Walk, isn't it?
Yes, so that's why we're hoping to make it an annual event and get all the talent that we can in and cooperating, and it should be fantastic. The gallery will be showing it tonight, as I said, and hope people can get along and have a look.
And David's actually going to be there to present the winning thingy.
Is that announced tonight?
Yes, it's been judged.
Oh, it's been judged.
So the winner. Bella Ivani. I said I was going to say Ella Bivani, but Bella Ivani judged it. So,
right.
So
it seems as if each artist has also come up with a theme. You have your obelisk.
The trig markers.
And there are a couple of works that have come out of that for you, including the nuclear submarine one.
Yeah.
Is that the case for you guys as well, Graeme and Wendy?
Yeah, it is, I probably have cut it a bit shorter than I normally would because I've got an exhibition coming up and I'm really madly painting for that. But I think I'm really looking forward to next year where we can really get a bit more time and a bit more knowing what's going to happen and get right into it.
Well, it's a great idea and it's certainly going to build, I'm sure. Thank you very much for coming in. And tonight is the night. Is everyone welcome to
6 p.m.? Yep.
Everybody.
I think everyone can come.
We want more than we can fit in.
Yeah.
The more success, the better.
Excellent stuff. All right. Well, thank you very much to our artists and thanks to our patron there in the studio as well, the sponsor, David Harkin. Thanks for coming in, David.
Thank you.
And a little bit of advice for artists when it comes to law. Graeme Balchard, Wendy Bills, David Harkin. And to you, Yanni Johns.
Hello, Mum.
Another great edition of Smart Arts. Now, this one will be up on YouTube, no doubt, by Monday.
Give me a couple of days, yeah.
People can have a look at some of the performers, including young Jacob Pearson, who played beautifully for us on air. 92.5 ABC Central
Coast. Listen, peeps, they're there. That's another Smart Arts. Bye.